好，我们首先敬礼传承祖师，敬礼了明和尚，敬礼沙迦正空上师，敬礼十六世大宝法王卡玛巴，敬礼图登达尔吉上师，我们敬礼坛城三宝，敬礼今天的护摩祖尊大孔雀明王，大孔雀明王经，大孔雀明王见属。师母，各位上师、教授师、法师、讲师、助教、堂主，以及各位同门，还有网络上的同门，今天仪会的贵宾，只有三位。这是很少有。中华民国驻瑞典兼挪威代表廖东洲大使夫人朱蒂师姐，中国中中委会会计师特丽莎师姐恩·哈斯曼，还有谢谢各地远地来的所有的同门贵宾，那现在先通知大家，下个礼拜天10月21日下午3点是勾财天女护摩法会。那么勾财天女是很有名的大家都知道的，他的手印是金刚勾印，它的种子日是红色的出力，它全身是红色的，那么结金刚钩，它的心咒是 Om Maro Hajya Hajya Om Inkusat InkusatShed, shed, shed, home, 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 pay, soha. 这个哈子啊，哈子啊，马哈哈子啊，就是勾财天女的名字，勾财天女的名。那么这一尊的主起的人一定很多勾财天女这个。人的本身的五大欲望，五个最大的欲望，作为首位的就是财、财、色、名、食、睡，是人本身的五大欲望。密教为什么也有财神法？主要是先与欲勾之，再令入佛道。先与欲勾之，再入这个佛道，也就是先用欲望让你满足这个欲望，然后再进入这个佛道里面。 这个主题者一定很多的啊，今天的主题者很少，然后一下子这个现哈达主题者现哈达，我手没有动几下就结束了，手没有动几下就结束了。他们不知道，难道你们不知道孔雀明王的威名吗？孔雀明王是很威名的啊，威名远播，在密教里面，孔雀明王是属于能够动这个定业的，很少数能够把定业能够改。但是孔雀明王象征着三尊的佛，第一个他头戴的是毗卢遮那大日如来观，他是毗卢遮那佛住在顶上，他戴的帽子是毗卢遮那佛戴的帽子，所以孔雀明王是毗卢遮那佛的一个化身。那么在西方极乐世界，阿弥陀佛的净土，他很多的波尔变化出很多阿弥陀佛啊，化出很多的鸟，其中有鹦鹉，有孔雀，有共命之鸟。这个孔雀是阿弥陀佛本身的变化身，阿弥陀佛本身所变化出来的，所以它又代表着毗卢遮那佛阿弥陀佛。另外有一个佛就是我们的教主释迦牟尼佛，他的本世经里面呢，就是本世经就是他的往世的，他曾经当过孔雀王，是释迦牟尼佛本身的受用身。孔雀王，释迦牟尼佛本身的受用身，所以这个孔雀明王啊，是毗卢遮那佛、释迦牟尼佛跟阿弥陀佛三尊合一的变化身，是他是最有威力的。那今天主持者非常少，这个大概你们不知道孔雀明王的来历。那想想看，而且呢，他手上有四个宝物。他有一个手是拿着吉祥果，吉祥果，你修法当中能够跟孔雀明王相应了，你一切都是吉祥的，因为他手上有吉祥果，一切都是吉祥的。另外他有一只手是拿着聚缘果，聚缘果是什么呢？聚缘果就是说你心中所想的这个缘分都能够得到的， 这个叫聚缘果，聚缘果，心中所想的缘分你都可以得到的。缘分不是咽喉的粪便而是真实的缘分啊！你在这世间上你要有很多的贵人，聚缘果就是贵人，你要很好的贤内助，要得到很好的这个很好的 husband 先生，都是要聚缘果的。那么再来呢，他的手上还有一个白莲花，白色的莲花在手上，只是象征着他能够消除所有本身的业障，一切恶运都可以消除掉。这白色的莲花是习斋的，消除所有的恶运。再来，他有四只手，最后一只是孔雀鱼。孔雀鱼是可以消灭离魔魍魉，所有的恶鬼恶神全部都可以消除掉的，甚至于杠头都可以消除掉。你只要跟这个孔雀明王啊，有相应，那么具有很大的缘，你跟他有很大的缘分，那你主起这一尊，你就获得了习斋、增益、降伏、敬爱，全部通通都获得，还有三尊佛的加持力。所以今天你们没有主起，这是很可惜。他本身来讲也具有还境的能力，还境，你本来是污秽的，经过孔雀明王的灌顶以后你就清净了，他有这一种能力的。另外他孔雀明王经里面有写到，好像念几遍的咒，念他的咒语，六十万遍的咒语，它可以清除你本身累世所有的业障。这么好的孔雀明王，居然主起者不多，那么勾财天女就上百位好啊，你讲啊。那很好啊，那恭喜你了得到佛手还得了。嗯，我们都大部分的人都是临时抱佛脚你可以得到佛手，那就是上乘的啊。对呀，这单单他那一只孔雀就不得了了，何况是这个三个佛。另外他有很多眷属的哦，你知道吗？你只要这一尊相应了，你会相应了什么呢？ 我告诉你，孔雀明王的海会眷属，他的眷属上面有七佛，他的头顶上有七佛，中央呢有弥勒菩萨，左右呢有圆觉跟声闻，有八大天王，二十八夜叉，就是二十八星宿，二十八星宿，九曜十二宫，全部都是孔雀明王的眷属，包括七佛、弥勒、圆觉、声闻、八天王、二十八星宿、九曜、十二宫，全部都是孔雀明王的眷属，所以他眷属非常的多啊，眷属非常的多。这部经是孔雀明王经，是释迦牟尼佛所讲的啊。现在你们如果要献哈达的话，还要做主起的话啊，等这个说完，你再来献哈达还是可以的。啊，今天这个孔雀明王，他其中有很多的做法，很多的做法，我以前已经讲过了。孔雀明王是在哪里传的？在西雅图传的。哇，在西雅图传的，那你们都应该要听过了。结果一下子你们忘掉，你以为孔雀明王是只是一只孔雀在飞啊？啊，不一样的。跟大家讲好，那等一下会有孔雀明王的灌顶，我看你们还是做灌顶就算了。那好好的念这个孔雀明王咒啊，六十万遍。你看孔雀明王咒很简单的 ，Om Moili Gadi Soha，Om Moili Gadi Soha。这样子念六十万遍，孔雀明王他本身就可以现身。那今天我再讲一下那个我去巴拿马的这个见闻，算是见闻。有一天的早上，在巴拿马有一天早上，天还是黑的，突然之间这房间，我的房间里面出现了这个霞光，霞光好像早上起来的那个太阳升起来的那种霞光啊，从窗帘里面这样子射出来，我看到觉得很奇怪，外面天还是黑的，怎么有这个七彩的这个霞光啊，这样子射进来啊，我就赶快起身，打开窗帘望向外面，天空中有几个光点，有几个光点从我的窗子那边飞过去。
And then I ask, where are you going?
他们就回答。
And they replied,
长虹雷藏寺有这个
to the 长虹雷藏 temple,
法会，开光的法会。
There was a consecration ceremony.
他们是去参加。
So they were attending the consecration ceremony of the Changhong Temple.
神仙啊，很多的波叶光放出七彩的光，
many prajna lights
经过我的窗前
，radiating colorful light.
然后去参加。
passing through, passing by my window. So I was curious and I asked. Because in the past, Changhong Temple only invited one master who was XX. So the statues inside Changhong Temple were already consecrated by XX. Did you attend it then? So these holy sages, did you attend her consecration? And they replied, no,
did not attend.
And I asked, why not? And pay attention to their answer. They only said one statement.
他说：“叉叉的开光啊，” 就是把他所养的鬼,
the consecration of XX was to send the ghost that she employed into the statues. So that's the so-called consecration of XX, is to send the ghost into or inside the statues. So remember this. So her consecration is she is sending the ghost that she employed into the statues. So have you read the XX Hall's introduction or brochure? This is a very important issue. How come you don't show any care? It was written very clearly in the XX Hall brochure or introduction. And it was written the origin of her ghost. From where? From the four great hells and ghosts from here and ghosts, what kind of ghosts? Because she could not raise all these ghosts by herself, so she distributed them into all the different temples and chapters to have them raised there. And she especially stated that inside the Changhong Temple in Panama, there's the most ghosts there.
Panama, 代他供养这些鬼. 另外还有很多的寺堂会, 它是通过放,
so Panama was the one that offered to the ghosts on her behalf. And then it said that all the temples all over the world are making offering to her ghosts, and especially she specifically mentioned Panama. So did you ever tidy up or clean or fix or repair the statues of the Changhong Temple in Panama? Anyone here who helped the cleaning? Before the ceremony this time, many masters and monks there helped cleaning them. There were some statues who have dropped their implements, and the paints on their faces were peeling off, and many statues were handicapped, incomplete, lost their paints, and rotten crowns, like the crown of Padma Kumara. Because the crown was very dirty, so we asked Grandmaster to give one. Thank you. And then in the room that I rested, next door had statues that were offered by XX, including the Tanka. Yes. Some were brought over by Reverend Lian Jing. They were from X place. The first consecration was the consecration was first done by XX first. Now you can ask the directors of the Changhong Temple to go to the Grand Master's resting room to see each of the Tanka carefully and to see the faces on the Tankas in that room. The faces have changed. The face on each of the Tanka, they all have changed. So the faces of the deities. And you say, right. Did you see it? No. But whatever you said is right. So you ask those from the Changhong Temple to go to that room where Grandmaster rested and to check each of the face on the Tanka and see if they look like ghosts. That all the faces appear to be like ghosts, to be ghost-like. So her consecration is the same as sending her ghost into the image. I didn't say this, it's because I saw the colorful rainbow light, Prajna light, and many deities that I saw, and said that the so-called consecration by XX was sending her ghost into the statues and images. Before consecration, many people saw the faces of the statues to be different, but after the consecration, it's different now.
Oh, Amitabha.
The pain on each of the statues was peeling. Okay, thank you.
So I would like to share what I experienced in
Panama. In going to the Changhong Temple. And then I consecrated it again.
And
I heard that the people who cleaned and have held those statues are being invaded by the ghosts and the spirits. And after the consecration, they got rid of those ghosts or the negative energies. So I hope you know about this more or better. So Reverend Lian Ying, he's also suffering a little bit of disturbances to Reverend Lian Ying is not disturbed, but you can help your dad and mom to purify them. So, because you were there, your mom and dad also got some disturbances, so you go home and help them purify it. And we all know Master Lian Tong's dad helped XX Hall's altar at the Guanyin district in Taiwan. So he made the altar. So Master Lian Tong's father had passed away. When he was alive, he took a video of this XX hall and showed it to us. And there was a tombstone that was brought from
Beitou,
a ghost temple, or the Yin temple in Beitou, and they brought it down and did not know where to put it. And then he put it in to Guoxing village in Nantou for a period of time, and there were two nuns staying there. Lian Ya and the place of that tombstone, there were two people staying there. In Nantou,
Guoxing.
So Lian Ya and Lian Kang now have all passed away.
And
on that tombstone, it was written, the illustrious of all spirits. Now it is enshrined at the Guanyin district, or the former Guanyin village of Taoyuan. There were two bungalows, and one of them, she set up the shrine for the XX Hall, and inside it, she enshrined this tombstone from the ghost temple. And on it, there's an inscription that said, the illustrious all spirits. Please raise your hand higher, not like this. Do you have photos? Yes. So that was built by Master Lian Tong's father, a picture that he took after he finished the renovation. So at those times, Master Lian Tong's father was also invaded by spirits, negative spirits, very severely. When he got home, he sweep off all the Buddhas and deities from his altar. He could not sleep at night, and the ghost told him to have the hairstyle of a Japanese samurai, and also asking him to die. So I tried my best to help him. Unsuccessfully, so he has died now too.
So 大家要有明智, 明智,
So you have to have the
clear
discernment. You have to have the clear understanding. How come in the Buddhist temple you can worship or enshrine ghosts or illustrious
spirits?
That's like the nether world spirits, not like the spirits of the higher realm. You know, because the spirits of the nether world refers to ghosts. So like if it is the gods and the higher spirits, it's okay. Or the boundless Buddha Dharma, that's okay. Or the illustrious Buddha power. So you need to have the right discernment. You need to be able to discern what is the real one and what is ghostly. You need to be clear about it. So today we will continue on Lamdre. So here we are talking about the goal and the fruit of fruition. The ultimate goal and the renyun or mastery fruit of perfect Sambhogakaya self-nature will be explained in the fruit section later. So the ultimate meaning, the highest attainment of Buddhahood will be explained later. And here it mentioned about wisdom empowerment, the third empowerment. And in the past, we refer to them as vase empowerment, inner tantra empowerment, highest yoga tantra empowerment, and great perfection empowerment. And wisdom empowerment belongs to the highest yoga tantra empowerment. And about the wisdom empowerment, there's the path, realization, the main goal, moment of death, and fruit. And in the broad term, first it talks about the pure, bright seal. And what is the bright seal? It's like karma mudra. So that's like bright seal means consort, so pure consorts. So the body and the speech are equal. And awe and desire are equal, and the blessings are equal, and the fifth instruction of the absorption, and then the beginning part, main part, and ending part of the practice. And it also talks about visualization development stages of the four bliss, and then the placement of the four bliss, outer and inner, the cut off of the four bliss and the disposition of the four bliss. These are just titles, and I will explain it later. By dwelling on the ambrosia of the causal position as the path of perfect body, here are the instructions on the five dharma belonging to the third empowerment or wisdom empowerment. So five methods. One is the path, that's the convenient path of the altar. The realization is the wisdom of the innate four bliss. The main goal is the narrow and minuscule bliss and emptiness. And at the moment of death or nearing death is the descent of Vajrasattva. And the fruit is the renyun mastery of the Dharmakaya self-nature. Next is the path, is the convenient path of the altar. All of these are just the titles. Broad, pure, bright mudra or karma mudra. There are consorts that are inborn, or there are also consorts that's attained. So if the consorts are inborn, that's due to the affinity from the past lives, that in this life they still have this affinity. So that's why they are born with it. And the second kind is purified and sealed by the Guru. So they become one due to the Guru. So by abiding the precepts and by receiving the empowerment, yoga and meditation, yoga meditation.
So
these are all just titles.
And
the equality of the body and speech, the equality of the desires, the equality of the blessings, and the fifth instruction of the absorption, which includes descent, holding, returning, dispersing, and protecting. That's for the broad term. And then for the essential, that's the beginning, main, and ending part.
注意因为之果戒甘露，一言之灌顶而得地三灌顶，作为具有能净以法身的善言，作熏修串习者，以道坛城轮方便道，须作熏修，譬如吸温酥油之浊根净，方能满足油灯等之需要。由虚融化，融化虚火，然火虚才心，所表一之自提升中气，须以能表欲志，取解受熄乐。 乐，虚荣身之戒净分，净分荣虚随贪火，亦才熏欲相同，即必须清净明印等。好了，这里讲到第三灌顶啊，这里讲到第三灌顶。
This is talking about the third empowerment. Our two Buddha schools, third empowerment, is touch empowerment.
The
touch empowerment is, and what's mentioned here is from the ancient time. And because of the area ambrosia, one attained the third empowerment. What does it mean? Do you understand? Anyone understand? Please. Tell Grandmaster. I'm talking about the ancient time because Lamdre is from the ancient time, long ago by Virupa in India.
请问，注意因为之戒甘露。
What does it mean by dwelling on the ambrosia of the causal position? That one deceived the third empowerment. Any of the masters know? Let me tell you about the empowerment in the ancient
time.
Should I say it explicitly or implicitly? Explicitly and
okay.
then don't feel yuck about it.
你们要听白的，我就讲白的。
Okay, so if you want to hear it explicitly, then I would tell you.
什么叫做因为？
So what is the causal position? Because the fruit has not attained. That's at the beginning.
比如我人生，我的人是身体。
Like this human body.
人的身体的甘露是什么？
So the sweet nectar inside the human body or in my body is this is the white body descending all the way to the secret chakra. For empowerment, and the secretion from the secret chakra is to be given to your consort. This way, you would receive the third empowerment. So the lineage root guru's white body just a drop of that body given to the girl placed inside the girl. That's called the third empowerment. So that's quite explicit, right? But not nowadays. Nowadays we don't do that. In the past we did that. Your guru would emit that secret drop and would be swollen through the mouth of the girl, then you receive the third empowerment
that way.
And the consort, that light drop, is the good affinity to purify. And the path is the convenient path of the altar. And you need to practice. So the difference between a clean and dirty. So the root guru's light drops is pure. If he is not a guru and has not practiced, so that would be filthy or dirty. Then it would not be suitable for purification. Only the pure light drop can be used. If it is a contaminated or adulterated one, cannot be used for purification. So that's the difference between the authentic or the genuine versus the fake one or the false one. And the authentic one sometimes is very colorful, seven color light drop. If it is white or it is muddy, then that's just a normal or regular one. So now you understand that. So this is the convenient path. So You need to practice. So the oil lamp has to be clean. Then it has to be pure. And the oil or the candle has to be melted. And in order for it to melt, you need the fire and to burn it.
And
So the light drop is actually the wisdom. That's why it's called the wisdom empowerment in the ancient time. That's what it's called. And the sensation is bliss. And the bliss, this kind of bliss is a pure kind of bliss. It's not the ordinary mundane bliss. There is a difference. There is a kind of bliss that's mundane, and there's a kind of bliss that's pure. So the ambrosia needs the fire of greed or the fire of desire. So desire, anger, and ignorance are all Buddha Dharma. So it follows the fire of desire in order to do it. So to this you need to have a pure consort. At the highest yoga tantra level, you need a pure consort. And how to perform the empowerment, like I just explained, for the ancient time. In the modern times, we don't have that. Nowadays, we use the touch empowerment. We use the pen to touch. Use the pen to touch. So that's why we have to have two people. So for you to practice the wisdom empowerment of the highest yoga tantra, you have to bring your companion and to receive the empowerment together. And nowadays we use water, pen. Nowadays we use a pen and water to touch. Not using the method of the ancient time, which is the light drops of the guru. So do you understand this part? But you have to pay attention. If you have practiced it, that the male guru is already non-leaking, has his inner fire arised, ignited, and he has generated a clear light radiance, and he has comprehended empty nature. Only then he has the qualification to confer the third empowerment. Or to receive the third level empowerment. Otherwise, you are not qualified. Although it is a convenient path, but ultimately it can become the ultimate path. So the third empowerment of Tantrayana is about this. Like Guru Tsongkhapa did not have any consort or karma mudra. So he attained Buddhahood at the Bardu state. And if you have a consort, then you can attain Buddhahood by transforming into light. You don't have to go through the Bardu state. And the two people can transform into light and attain Buddhahood directly. Like Guru Padmasambhava, he had a consort. And the two of them together transformed to become fire, and then to become light, and then to enter into the sky. That's attaining Buddhahood through transformation into light. And that's Buddhahood in this body, in this lifetime. So in this body, you can attain Buddhahood without going through the bardo state. But Tsongkhapa did attain Buddhahood in bardo state because he did not have a consort, he did not receive third empowerment.
So,
the outer, you can stop all kind of discernments, and that's why it's called the non-discernment.
And then,
The real mudra is the physical consort, and then the wisdom mudra, which is in the sky. And then they are divided into the broad and the essential path. We will continue next time. That's all for today. Let me tell you what the boss said. The boss said, after work, he's asking Xiaoming, do you have time after work? I want to invite you for dinner. And Xiaoming said, sure, you're so nice. And then the boss said to the secretary, let's get one more box tonight. Xiaoming is going working overtime. So we use desire to hook you inside and then lead you onto the Buddha's path. So first the boss said inviting him for dinner, and then it turned out to be overtime. The wife told the husband, honey, did you ever have an experience to be lied to? And the husband was very angry. Yes, before marriage you told me that you will not gain weight no matter what you eat. And he was lied. So before and after marriage is a different thing, even the figure changes. Xiaoming asked Xiaohua, what day is September 28th? And Xiaohua replied, I know, it's the birthday of Confucius. And Xiaoming asked again,
10月28号呢?
How about October
28th?
And Xiaohua said, I don't know. And Xiaoming said, you're so dumb. That's the 1 month celebration of Confucius. Like the 1 month old baby party. The grandson asked the grandma, Grandma, what does it mean to be? Words of enormous weight is that I say one word and you oppose me 9 times. That's a play of words in Chinese. If you don't have personal experience about Lamdre, then you would never understand reading it. What it's talked about, the real mudra, that's the physical consort, and the wisdom mudra, that's the consort in the sky.
别人讲不出来的。
So this can only be explained by Grandmaster,
你看吗?
But not anybody else.
注意因为之戒甘露一眼之灌顶。
By dwelling on the ambrosia of the causal position as the path of perfect body, it's the third empowerment. So, the ambrosia, that's the white body, so the white body inside the guru's body. So, that's the ambrosia at the causal position.So the ambrosia of sweet nectar is the pure ambrosia of the guru. That's the best. But the nectar of ordinary people is the filthy ambrosia or the polluted ambrosia. That's for bearing children. So the causal position ambrosia, the pure ambrosia, seven rainbow color light, and spiritual cultivators, belonging to spiritual cultivators, but the ordinary beings just muddy white color. This can only be explained by Grandmaster.This is related to us. Xiao Ming asks his dad, Daddy, why do we place a pencil on the back of a horse? So that symbolizes instant money, like we have the instant money practice of Golden Mother. So getting home, Xiao Ming was drawing something, and the dad asked, what are you drawing? And the Xiao Ming replied that he is drawing like a New Year's wish card.So to send it to the uncle in China. So you're drawing a camel? No, this is not camel. This is like instant second boob. Actually, but second boob is like a mistress. So on top of the horse, there are like two boobs.
你看这个你们都听得懂刚刚我讲
了 So now you understand this.
我不讲你们听不懂
But
我讲了
Earlier you will not understand without my explanation. You would understand after I explain it.
非常感谢圣经财宝贵的法语开示请大家把各自